So let us look at some interesting questions from indices. Let's take the first one. Okay, so the first question is 64 upon 125 the whole raised to minus 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 divided by 1 upon 256 upon 625 256 upon 625 the whole raised to 1 by 4 multiplied by root 25 upon cube root of 64. Let's see how to do this question. So in this chapter indices, the concept is very simple. It is based on the laws of indices which you have done in 8th class also, but there are a few questions which can be a little bit difficult. You can understand those questions only by knowing how to solve the questions. So in this video, you will understand how to solve these kind of questions, right? Pay attention. Okay, now in the first fraction over here, what is the denominator of the power? The denominator of the power is 3. That means if I want to simplify this first fraction, I need to express the numerator and denominator of the fraction in terms of power of 3. So 64, whose cube is 64? 4 cube. And 125 is 5 cube. And the whole raised to minus 2 by 3. So that's the first step. Let's go ahead. Now the same thing has to be done with the second fraction, in which the denominator is 256 by 625 raised to 1 by 4. What is the power of denominator? 4. So you need to express 256 as 4th power of some number. What raised to 4 is 256? Now if you see, 256 is 16 square and 16 is 4 square. So 4 raised to 4 is 256 and 625 is 5 raised to 4. 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, if you multiply 5 with itself 4 times, you get 625. So you must know these powers at least, you know, your table should be good, then you can solve this easily. Root 25 is 5 and cube root of 64 again is 4. Okay, now what will happen over here? This 4 by 5 will remain inside. The whole power will become 3. See, 3 is power of both 5, 4 and 5. You remember the identity, if a raised to b, a raised to m. If it is given a raised to m upon b raised to m, you can write it as a by b, the whole raised to m. I'm using this law of exponents or indices. And there is one more law which says that a raised to m the whole raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n. So what I'm doing here is I'm multiplying the combined power of 4 upon 5, that is 3, with the power which is outside the bracket, that is minus 2 by 3. Okay, so this divided by 1 upon the same thing over here, 4 by 5 the whole raised to 4 into 1 by 4 multiplied by 5 by 4. Okay, let's take it down. This 3 and this 3 will cut. So 4 by 5 the whole raised to minus 2 divided by this 4 and this 4 will cut, 1 upon 4 by 5 multiplied by 5 by 4. Okay, so this 4 by 5 raised to minus 2, you remember the identity, a raised to minus m is equal to 1 upon a raised to m. So this will become 1 upon 4 by 5 the whole raised to 2. If you take reciprocal, the power will change its sign. So if it is negative, it will become positive. Divide by 1 upon 4 upon 5 will become 5 upon 4 multiplied by 5 upon 4. Don't be in a hurry to multiply these two. Okay, I will tell you why. So this will become 1 upon 16 upon 25 divided by 5 upon 4 into 5 upon 4. Okay, let's take it down. Okay. So this will become 1 upon 16 upon 25 will become 25 upon 16. I'm sorry. Okay. Now there is division sign and then there is 5 by 4. Can I write multiplication sign and then reciprocal this, like 4 upon 5 into 5 upon 4? Yes, definitely. Why did I do that? Because the division, when get converted into multiplication, the number which is after the division sign becomes its reciprocal, right? So 5 by 4 becomes 4 by 5. So here 5 and 5 will cut, 4 and 4 will cut. The answer will be 25 by 16. This is your final answer. Okay, this is improper fraction. Okay, improper fraction means numerator is bigger than the denominator. So you must convert it into a mixed fraction. 16, 1s are 16 plus 9, 25. So 1, 9 by 16. So that is your final answer. Okay, let's try one more question. I will solve as many questions as I can so you guys can understand how to solve the questions from the exercise. 27 raised to 4 by 3 plus 32 raised to 0.8 plus 0.8 raised to minus 1. Okay, 27. I have to express 27 as a number with power 3. Easy, 3 cube. 3 cube is 27 raised to 4 by 3 plus, okay, 32. What is 32? 32 is 2 raised to 5. Now here there is 0.8. There is no denominator, but I can write 0.8 as 8 by 10 plus 0.8 raised to minus 1. Now we just saw one identity where anything raised to minus power becomes its reciprocal. So it will become 1 upon 0.8. Right? So this will become 3 raised to 3 into 4 by 3 plus 2 raised to 5 into 8 by 10 plus 1 by 0.8. So this 3 gets cut with this 3. This 5 gets cut with this 10, and that's it. So 3 raised to 4 plus okay, this 2 gets cut with this 8, so it will become 2 raised to 4 plus 1 by 0.8. okay, this will become 10 by 8. If I multiply numerator and denominator by 10, it will become 10 by 8. So 3 raised to 4 is 81 plus 2 raised to 4 is 16 plus this is 2 5s are 2 4s are 5 by 4, right? 81 plus 16 plus 5 by 4. So this is 97 plus 97 plus, if you divide 5 by 4, you get 5 divided by 4, 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, you get 1.25. So the answer will be 98.25. So that's the answer. Right? Okay, let's do one more question from this particular part. Okay, so next question is, in square brackets, 5. What I'm showing you here is how to solve these questions, right? So you will find some similar questions in the exercise. So by seeing how I am solving them, what identities I am using them, what are my steps, what you will be able to learn is how to solve them yourself. Right, so first simplifying 8 raised to 1 by 3 and 27 raised to 1 by 3 by writing it this way: 5 bracket 2 cube raised to 1 by 3 plus 3 cube raised to 1 by 3. Okay, now the whole thing is under a cube and the whole thing is raised to 1 by 4. Okay, so this will become 5 bracket 2 raised to 3 into 1 by 3 plus 3 raised to 3 into 1 by 3, the whole raised to 3, the whole raised to 1 by 4. Here 3 and 3 will cut. This 3 and 3 will also cut. So here you will be left with 2 plus 3, the whole raised to 3, the whole raised to 1 by 4. So this will become 5 multiplied by 2 plus 3 is 5 cube, the whole raised to 1 by 4. This can be written as 5 raised to 1 plus 3, the whole raised to 1 by 4. You understand how did I write this? You remember this: a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. So here 5 raised to 1 into 5 raised to 3 is 5 raised to 1 plus 3. That is 5 raised to 4. Raised to 1 by 4 means 1 into 1 by 4. 4, 4 will cut. So 5 raised to 1. That is your answer for 5 raised to 1 or 5, that is your answer for this question. Let's go to the next question. 1176. At any point in the video, if you want to stop and pause or re-watch the part which I just taught you, if you did not understand, you are welcome to do so. That is the benefit of YouTube lectures over live. Live classes are okay, but for mathematics I feel that you need your time and your space to understand the concept, right? Okay, so they have given you this equation, sort of. 1176 is equal to 2 raised to p into 3 raised to q into 7 raised to r. You have to find the numerical value of p, q and r, and second thing you need to find is the value of 2 raised to p multiplied by 3 raised to q multiplied by 7 raised to minus r as a fraction. So you need to find these two things. For finding these two things, first you need to find the prime factors of 1176, because here, as you can see, 116 is represented as factors of 2, 3 and 7. That means these are the factors of 1176. Let's see. So 2, if we divide by 2, 2 5s are 10, 2 8s are 16, 2 8s are 16 again, 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 9s are 18, I'm sorry, some mistake, maybe not a mistake, I don't know. 2 2s are 4, 1, yeah, 2 9s are 18, 2 4s are 8. Correct, it was correct. Again, 2, 1, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8, 2 7s are 14. Now 4 plus 1, 5 plus 7 is 12, so it will go by 3. 3 4s are 12, and 3 9s are 27. 7 7s are 49, and 7 1s are. Therefore, 1176 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 7. So 1176 can again be written as 2 raised to 3 into 3 raised to 1 into 7 raised to 2. So if you compare it with your question over here, you get P as 3, Q as 1, and R as 2. Now you found PQR. What will be 2 raised to P? 2 raised to P will be 2 raised to 3 multiplied by 3 raised to 1 multiplied by 7 raised to minus 2. So this will be 8 into 3 upon 7 raised to 2. Why this went into the denominator? Because of the negative sign of the power. So this will become 24 upon 49. That is your final answer. So very easy, right? Let's do one more question. Okay, so this one, please pay attention. There are questions like this, and there is a reason why I'm doing this chapter after expansion and factorization. The reason is because if you see the questions, some of the questions, they have use of algebraic identities. We have just done algebraic identities. It's fresh in our mind. So you will see that we will be able to solve this easily, right? Also, it's a small chapter. It should be over early. A raised to N upon A raised to L. This is L. If you don't see it clearly, then I will write it like this. Okay, so that's L raised to N plus L. Okay, there's no need to put bracket, but still I'll put this also in bracket. And A raised to L upon A raised to M, the whole raised to L plus M. Okay, so what we need to do is simplify. The question is simplify. Okay, see, A raised to M upon A raised to N. You know that A raised to M upon A raised to N is what? A raised to M minus N. Now there is whole raised to M plus N. Now this M plus N will multiply with M minus N. Right? Similarly here, N minus L bracket N plus L over here. L minus M L plus M. So this will become A raised to M square minus N square, A raised to N square minus L square into A raised to L square minus M square. Okay, so this will, okay, this will be A raised to M square minus N square plus N square minus L square plus L square minus M square. So this M square will cut with this M square minus M square will cut. This L square will cut with minus L square. This N square will cut with minus N square. And this will become A raised to 0. Now you remember, what is anything raised to 0? Anything raised to 0 is always 1. So the answer is 1. So this is simplified. So here we use this identity A plus B into A minus B, which is A square minus B square, right? So algebraic identities are useful in some of the questions of indices. And that's why it is easier to do indices after immediately after algebra, right? Let's do the next question. Okay. So this question is solve for X. Okay. In this, the first one, I'll take an easy one first. 9 into 3 raised to x is equal to 27 the whole raised to 2x minus 5. So you have to solve for x. How to solve for x? See, okay, here I can write it as 3 square into 3 raised to x is equal to 3 cube the whole raised to 2x minus 5. See how I'm simplifying. I'm trying to write everything in as the base of 3. So this will become 3 raised to 2 plus x, a raised to m into a raised to n is a raised to m plus n, and this will become 3 raised to 2, sorry, 3 raised to 3 bracket 2x minus 5. The powers multiplied, a raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m into n. So 3 raised to 2 plus x is equal to 3 raised to 3 bracket 2x minus 5, right? So this will become 3 raised to 2 plus x is equal to 3 raised to 6x minus 15. This 3 got multiplied with both of them, right? So now what we'll do? Now see the statement which I am going to write. When a raised to m is equal to b raised to n and a is equal to b, then, and if a is equal to b, then m is equal to n. Remember this statement. What do you understand by this statement? So if it says that if the exponents are same, right, that is the one number raised to another number, that is an exponent. If the exponents are same, how they are same? Because there is equal to sign in between them, so they are same. And if the bases are same, bases are this 3, this is known as a base, right? If the bases are same, then the power has to be same. M and n are power. Here what is the power? 2 plus x is the power, and on the right hand side 6x minus 15. So we can directly equate the power. So what will it become? 2 plus 15 is equal to 6x minus x. So 17 is equal to 5x. So 17 by 5 is equal to x, which is equal to 32 by 5. So the value of x is 32 by 5 in mixed fraction. So you understand how to solve this? First, we simplified them and made sure that both had same basis. When both the exponents had same basis, we just equated the power, and by equating the power, we got the answer. So this is the method for this kind of question. Let's do one more question based on this. Under root of 3 by 5 raised to 1 minus 2x, and then the whole thing is under root, is equal to 4 17 upon 27. It's a weird looking question, but has to be solved. Let's see. First, I will convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 27 4s are 7, 4s are 28, 2 4s are 8 plus 2, 10, and 108 plus 17 is equal to 125, right? So this will be nothing but 125 upon 27. Okay, let us see on the left hand side what we get. Can I write this as 3 by 5 the whole raised to 1 minus 2x, I'm sorry, 1 minus 2x the whole power 1 by 2, See what I did? I removed the root and I wrote the power of 1 by 2. Under root means if you have a number root of a, you can write it as a raised to 1 by 2. If it is cube root of a, then you can write it as a raised to 1 by 3. Remember, this is also an identity, okay? This is also law of exponents. All right, so this will be equal to 125 upon 27. So this can be written as, on the left hand side, 3 by 5 the whole raised to 1 minus 2x upon 2 is equal to 125 by 27. So this can be written as 5 cube upon 3 cube, right? Okay, so this will be 3 by 5 the whole raised to 1 minus 2x upon 2 is equal to 5 by 3 the whole raised to 3. Now here you have the base 3 by 5 and here you have 5 by 3. You cannot equate them now. You cannot equate the power right away. So see what I am doing. 3 by 5 raised to 1 minus, oops, my handwritings are pathetic. Write it all over again, okay? So 3 by 5 the whole raised to 1 minus 2x upon 2 is equal to 3 by 5 the whole raised to minus 3. You remember this? A by B the whole raised to m can be written as B by A the whole raised to minus m, right? So I took a reciprocal and the power became negative. Now both the bases are equal. Now I can equate the power. So the power will become 1 minus 2x by 2 is equal to minus 3. That is 1 minus 2x is equal to minus 3 into 2. So 1 minus 2x is equal to minus 6. So minus 2x is equal to minus 6 plus 1. Or minus 2x is equal to minus 5. Or x is equal to minus 5 upon minus 2. Or x is equal to 5 by 2. And that is 2 1 by 2. So your final answer for x should be, okay, so they are getting 3.5 here. I got 2.5. So I made a mistake. What mistake did I make? 1 minus 2x upon 2 is equal to minus 3. So 1 minus 2x is equal to minus 6. Oh, look at my mistake, my silly mistake over here. This should be minus 1. Plus 1 comes this side and becomes minus 1. So this should be, the whole thing is wrong. So I also make silly mistakes. It's not only you. Anyone can do it. But the only thing is to learn from it. I'm learning till now. Okay, so minus 2x is equal to minus 7. Minus minus cuts. X is equal to 7 by 2. That is 3.5. So that's your final answer. The value of x. I hope you understand this kind of questions now. How to find x, solve for x. It's better if you, after watching the solution, if you again solve it, you will get a better grip on this. One more question like this. 2 raised to 2x plus 3. 2 raised to 2x plus 3 minus 9 into 2 raised to x plus 1 is equal to 0. What is the question? Solve. The question is just solve. Right? So if the question is just solve, that means you have to find the value of x. Okay, let's see how to find it. Let me just simplify this, okay? Can I write it as 2 raised to 2x multiplied by 2 raised to 3 minus 2 raised to x into 9. 9 into 2 raised to x I have written as 2 raised to x into 9, doesn't make any difference, is equal to, there cannot be 2 is equal to, only 1 is equal to 0. Okay, this I can write it as 2 raised to x the whole square, right? 2 raised to 2x is nothing but 2 raised to x raised to 2. If you open the bracket, x and 2 will multiply and again become 2x into 2 raised to 3, I will write it as 8 minus 2 raised to x into 9 plus 1 is equal to 0. Now see what I am doing. Let 2 raised to x is equal to y. I will use a method of substitution. You must be very much aware of this method now because you have done factorization. In factorization, there were certain questions like this. So y square, 8y square actually, 8 into y square. This is y, 2 raised to x. Okay, and the whole square. So 8y square minus 9y plus 1 is equal to 0. So this is nothing but a quadratic equation. I will factorize by splitting the middle term. So 8 into 1 is plus 8, and factors of plus 8 such that I get minus 9 is 8 ones are 8, minus 8 minus 1. Minus 8 multiplied by minus 1 is plus 8, minus 8 minus 1 is minus 9. So 8y square minus 8y minus y plus 1 is equal to 0, right? So this will become 8y, 8y gets common, y minus 1, minus 1 is common, y minus 1. So 8y minus 1 and y minus 1, both product is equal to 0. Therefore, solving this further, now these steps you didn't do in factorization. See, this is something new. Therefore, 8y minus 1 is equal to 0, or y minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, 8y is equal to 1, or y is equal to 1. Therefore, y is equal to 1 by 8, or y is equal to 1. Right? So these are the two values of y. But we didn't have to find y. We had to find x. So what is y? Y is 2 raised to x. Right? So 2 raised to x is equal to 1 by 8. Or 2 raised to x is equal to 1. Let me solve this. Now this is really interesting. See. Okay. So can I write it as 2 raised to x is equal to 1 upon 2 cube? And can I write this as 2 raised to x is equal to 2 raised to 0? Anything raised to 0 is 1. Remember that. So 2 raised to x is equal to 2 raised to minus 3, or 2 raised to x is equal to 2 raised to 0. Why minus 3? Why did I get minus 3? Because if I take reciprocal, the power becomes negative, right? Therefore, x is equal to minus 3, or x is equal to 0. These are the two values of x, and this is the method with which you solve it, right? Let's do the next question. Okay, this one seems big. 1 upon 1 plus x raised to b minus a plus x raised to c minus a plus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to a minus b plus x raised to c minus b plus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to b minus c plus x raised to a minus c is equal to 1, and you have to prove that. This is the question about prove that. PT means prove that. How do I prove this? So first I will take LHS. LHS means left hand side. For any prove that problem, first you have to solve left hand side and try to simplify as much as you can and make it equal to right hand side. If it does not become equal to right hand side, then in that case you have to solve right hand side also and try to make it equal to the simplified left hand side. But in this case, our right hand side is 1. So we have to simplify the left hand side whole thing, whole equation, and try to make it 1. Okay, let's see how to do it. So left hand side is 1 upon 1 plus x raised to b minus a. Can I write it as x raised to b upon x raised to a plus x raised to c upon x raised to a? Yes. And here I'll write it as 1 plus x raised to a the whole upon x raised to b plus x raised to c upon x raised to b plus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to b upon x raised to c plus x raised to a upon x raised to c. Cool. So what do we get over here? See, here I have to take LCM everywhere. All the fractions denominator needs an LCM. So here, what will be the LCM? See here, x raised to a, x raised to a. Here I will multiply by x raised to a, x raised to a. I'm sorry for that. X raised to a. Here the LCM will be x raised to b. Here the LCM will be x raised to c, right? Cool. So this will be 1 upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c the whole upon x raised to a plus 1 upon x raised to b plus x raised to a plus x raised to c the whole upon x raised to b plus 1 upon x raised to c plus x raised to b plus x raised to a the whole upon x raised to c. Now these denominators, like if you have 1 upon a upon b, this b will get multiplied with 1 and it will become b by a, right? So using this relation, we can solve it further. This will become x raised to a upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c plus x raised to b upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c plus x raised to c upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c. Now all the denominators are same, so you can simplify it as x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c the whole upon x raised to a plus x raised to b plus x raised to c. These both will get cut and you get the answer as 1, which is equal to your RHS. So therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. So that is how you solve this question, right? Let's go to the next question. Okay, this is very interesting, and there is a question like this in the exercise which mostly nobody can attempt, right? Let's see what is that. A is equal to B raised to 2x, B is equal to C raised to 2y, and C is equal to A raised to 2z. Show that 8x y z is equal to 1. Show that 8x y z is equal to 1. Okay. Let us try to understand this, how what they are trying to say. See, A is equal to B raised to 2x. Now, what is the value of B? The value of B is C raised to 2y. Okay, so in the place of B, I wrote C raised to 2y, the whole raised to 2x. So it will become C raised to 4xy. But what is the value of C? Value of C is A raised to 2z, the whole raised to 4xy, which is already there. In the place of C, I put the value of C, that is A raised to 2z. Here, A raised to 2z is given in the question. Now, if I simplify this, it will become A raised to 4 to the 8 x y z. So, A is equal to A raised to 8 x y z. Okay, here, what is the power of A? 1. Therefore, 8xyz is equal to 1. 8xyz is equal to 1. That is what we had to prove. Very easy, right? But tricky. You need to know the trick. Great. Let's do one more question, the last question for today. These are all solved examples I'm trying to show you. If I solve these, you will understand how to solve indices problems. That's why I'm showing you all these solved examples. If we would have been in class, I would have done the same thing. I first always solve all the solved examples, and then you have to solve the exercise so that you know that how to go about these kind of questions and you gain confidence. And any doubts, you can in anyways contact me, ask me the doubts, and I will let you know. Right? Let's go about the last question. If 2 raised to x is equal to 4 into 2 raised to y, and 9 multiplied by 3 raised to x is equal to 3 raised to minus y. We have to find the values of x and y. So this is kind of an equation which we will get. Let's solve them. Let's solve the first equation. 2 raised to x is equal to 4 into 2 raised to y. So 2 raised to x is equal to 2 square multiplied by 2 raised to y. So 2 raised to x is equal to 2 raised to 2 plus y, and therefore x is equal to 2 plus y. We got the value of x. We can also write it as x minus y is equal to 2. This is your equation number 1. Let's solve this one. This will become 3 square multiplied by 3 raised to x is equal to 3 raised to minus y. So this will be 3 raised to 2 plus x is equal to 3 raised to minus y. So we can equate the powers right away. 2 plus x is equal to minus y, or x plus y is equal to minus 2. Oh, I'm sorry. I had to write x plus y is equal to minus 2, equation number 2. This is your second equation, this is your first equation. Now how we'll solve both the equations? See. So adding equations 1 and 2. If you add both the equations, see what happens. X minus y is equal to 2 and x plus y is equal to minus 2 will give you minus y plus y will cut x plus x. This is the sign of addition. Okay. X plus x is equal to 2x and 2 minus 2 will be 0. So x is equal to 0 by 2, which is 0. So value of x is 0. Now substituting x is equal to 0 in equation 2. So 0 plus y is equal to minus 2. See, in the place of x, I just put 0. So y is equal to minus 2. So x is 0 and y is minus 2. So this is how you solve this question. And so if you see, I've solved a lot of questions for you guys from your solved examples. Okay. I hope you understood all the methods. And now I think you are ready to try the questions from the exercise 7A, 7B, and there is a miscellaneous exercise 7C. You can try all these exercises yourself, and you can finish it. Next week we can start with the next chapter, that is logarithm. Right? So see you in the next video. Bye bye.